Sunday today, and we're visiting the dental clinic first up near Long Tan, the village of. We're going through the village of Long Tan now, and in 66 it had been totally levelled. It's been rebuilt since the end of the occupation.
Completely
flattened, Norm tells me. And they've rebuilt it and repopulated it.
We have over here what's left of the Horseshoe, which is a permanent fire support base that we had. And here we could fire to the coast. It's been mined away. You can see the hole in it up there. What it was this. Almost a full circular or horseshoe shaped crater. And there's the road from Long Tan down to the coast with the usual plethora of motorbikes.
So we're now passing through Dat Do, which wasn't destroyed.
But in the years since the war, the limits of the township have expanded outwards. So the outskirts of Dat Do now covers all that minefield.
Looking back down the corridor where the famous minefield was laid, part of, looking back towards the back of Horseshoe, and it was down through this corridor here that a section of it was laid, near Dat Do.
Scott, do you think
that's a bug?
Dangerous?
Nah.
Not that we know of.
Norm's just showed me this bush was one of the bushes that they avoided like the plague. If you see all the spikes pointing backwards, you can understand why they wouldn't want that in their clothes, box, skin, socks, anywhere. Going through Dat Do, quite a large town, city. This is Long Hoi that we're going through.
This is as close as we can get to the area that the mine incident that's commonly called now the Frankie's Mine Incident, or the mine incident about which the song I was only 19 was written. The secondary reason for visiting this is that you've seen rubber plantation, you've walked through some cultivated areas, you've seen rice paddy, and you've reasonably assessed that that's not where the VC hid. The VC hid in stuff like this, and therefore the main Australian infantry task was to patrol through stuff like this. So anyone that doesn't want to be seen, they can be standing, or they can be sitting, lying right beside the track, and you wouldn't see them. That's the mental strain, if you like, of patrolling. Now it's into this area that 6th Battalion came second tour, and They landed in an area and started to patrol around, and they triggered a mine. That day, from 9:40 and 13:15, with other incidents around, became immortalized in this song. And as it happens, Michael was in 6th Battalion 2nd Tour, and he wasn't with this company, A Company. He was with Battalion. So I'll hand over to Michael, and he'll have a couple of words about it.
Just going back a bit, in 1968, I joined the Battalion as a National Serviceman. I'd done all my training. Joined the Battalion and was allocated to A Company. And Lieutenant Hines was my platoon commander. he was a young, 21-year-old National Service officer. He was a pretty solid sort of guy. We came over to Vietnam and this incident happened. Armstrong just stepped on the moon. I was in the fire support base thrust, which was at the foot of the Long Highs, in a command tent there, and I was listening to that going on, the Armstrong saying, one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind. And at that moment, Lieutenant Hines walked across to his corporal, Corporal Neat, and went to tell him that Armstrong had stepped on the moon. As he did, Lieutenant Hines stepped on the mine and was killed. I was in the command tent listening to that on the radio, and the company radio was there. It came over the company radio that had been a mine incident. So all hell broke loose, there were messages going everywhere. 4.5 hours later, as David said, the battalion commander, Lieutenant Colonel David Butler, went out with the RMO, Captain Anderson. Captain Anderson was a young doctor, lieutenant. And the engineers were already out there, and they'd laid out tape around the safe areas so that no one walked out of the area that was cleared. Apparently, Captain Anderson, I don't know whether he stepped out of the marked area or what, but he saw a sign, the skull and crossbones sign, and he picked it up. It blew up, it blinded him, it injured the commanding officer, it wounded 22 other people. So that day was a pretty major day in my life over there. Mm-hmm.
Dad and Denny saw the passing out parade at Pakapanyul. It was a long march from cadets. The 6th Battalion was the next to tour, and it was me who drew the card. We did Canungra, Shoalwater before we left. And Townsville lined the footpaths as we marched down to the quay. This clipping from the paper shows us young and strong and clean. And there's me in me slouch hat with me SLR and greens. God help me. I was only 19. From Buntow riding Chinooks to the dust of Newy Dat, I'd been in and out of choppers now for months. And we made our tents a home VV and pin-ups on the lockers, and an Asian orange sunset through the scrub. And can you tell me, Doctor, why I still can't get to sleep? The night time's just a jungle dark and a barking M16. And what's this rash that comes and goes? Can you tell me what it means? God help me. I was only 19. A 4-week operation, when each step could mean your last one on two legs. It was a war within yourself, but you wouldn't let your mates down till they had you dusted off. So you closed your eyes and thought about something else. And then someone yelled out, "Contact!" And the bloke behind me swore. We looked in there for hours, then it got almighty raw. And Frankie kicked a mine the day that mankind kicked the moon. God help me. He was going home in June.
drinking tinnies in the Grand Hotel on a 36-hour reprieve in Vung Town. And I can still hear Frankie lying screaming in the jungle till the morphine came and killed the bloody row. And the Anzac legends didn't mention mud and blood and tears, and the stories that my father told me never seemed quite real. I caught some pieces in my back that I didn't even feel. God help me, I was only 19. And can you tell me, doctor, why I still can't get to sleep? And why the Channel 7 chopper chills me to my feet? And what's this rash that comes and goes? Can you tell me what it means? God help me, I was only 19.
Vietnam in June 7th.